everyone. Thank you so much for coming along today. I'm Betty and I've been travelling around Merseyside since the 1950s.
Bus Regulation the Musical is based on Andrew Lloyd Webber's Starlight Express. So it uses performers on roller skates to tell the story of public transport provision in the Merseyside region from the post-war period up to the present day and then going into the future.
In the 1960s, most buses in our towns and cities were run by municipal bus companies, owned by local authorities or corporations as they were called back then.
So Liverpool Corporation Transport, but then we had Wallasey Corporation, Birkenhead, Southport and St Helens, all running their own bus services. They're all publicly owned and run in the interest of the people who lived in those areas. After all of the big changes to our cities and urban areas that had happened in the post-war period, that people had been moved further out of city centres, areas like Merseyside had become conurbations and we needed a public transport system to match. Labour's 1968 Transport Act set up passenger transport executives to plan and integrate public transport so that it works seamlessly across the whole of the region.
On 1st December 1969, the Merseyside Passenger Transport Executive was formed, or MPTE for short. It inherited all of Liverpool Corporation buses, which became its north and south divisions.
There were great strides made in the 1970s towards integrating and coordinating public transport so that buses, trains and ferries work together as a whole so that people could get around easily. In 1986, there was a policy called bus deregulation, which was really disastrous, and we're still feeling the legacy of that now in the way our buses are run. Buses were no longer planned and coordinated.
Now anyone could start a bus company and run routes wherever they thought they could make the most money.
So services were really being driven by profit. They didn't want to connect the small villages, they didn't want to connect the small towns, so they just lost services. We lost millions of miles of routes and chaos ensued. And that's acted out in the musical by the skaters, all bundling into the city centre and bustling and trying to compete with each other. And just seeing it acted out on roller skates really illustrates, drives home the absurdity of that policy. So it's really important that we remember the history.
If you thought the 80s were chaos, things are about to go from bad to worse.
After you've got all these small companies that are started up, they start getting taken over, they start merging together, and gradually just a few big companies take over all of the buses. So they go back into a sort of a near monopoly state. And here in Merseyside, Arriva run over 60% of the buses. Stagecoach have pretty much the rest of the network. So it's just these two big multinational companies running the whole show. And there's no incentive for them to cooperate. And really what we need is a public body like Mersey Travel doing that planning and coordinating work, like what happened in the 1970s, so that we can actually have a public transport system like it's meant to work, where your buses, your trains and your ferries are all planned and coordinated to work together as part of one system. So the reason why we're doing the musical now is because bus re-regulation is on the horizon in the Liverpool city region. So it's a really exciting time. Last year, the Combined Authority released their plans to deliver a fully integrated public transport network, and the next stage will be a both public consultation on whether the public wants their buses re-regulated. So the musical's timed to coincide with that to create awareness. What on earth is bus regulation? This is what it is. This is how it's worked in the past, and this is how it can work in the future in the interest of our region's people.